everyone, the Chang here with a review on the Oakley Link MilTac backpack. I'm going to be using this, this of course the multicam version. I'm going to be using this as a replacement to my LA Police Gear Operator Pack that I use as a range bag. I'm going to do a long-term review on that LA Police Gear backpack. I'll put the link down in the description below. So I'm an Oakley freak and I have a bunch of Oakley stuff. I haven't really been into their bags. There's a lot of features that I believe are missing, and I'll go with other brand bags. Glasses, absolutely, but the bags, for me, historically, not so much. So I decided to give this a try. I wanted to kind of compress the size of the bag that I was using. Certain pieces of gear I'm just not really using at the range, so I may try to bring those in a separate container. But this bag has a very large main compartment. So we can go in here, if you guys can take a look at that. Sorry, I'm bumping the camera. Has a shoe compartment down here. That does take up a pretty large chunk here. So it's got a vent hole in case your shoes are wet. Does have laser cut molly here. A couple straps. Some molly on the side pockets. Velcro on these surfaces right here so you can put morale patches. The side pockets have pockets in them as well. There is a hydration bladder that's included. The hydration bladder is 2 liters, and there is the ability to actually put a laptop in here as well. So you can take this out, put a laptop in here. It does have, it does feel stiff, but it does not have an internal frame. So that's complaint for me, complaint number one. I prefer bags that have internal structure to them, so the bags hold shape, they're easier to move around, a little bit more support. The padding is really nice on the back here. It is sculptured, so you get some airflow so it doesn't get too hot. Not a huge fan of the fact that there is no waist strap here. Now, again, I'm just using this for a range bag, but if you were looking at one of these for, you know, hiking or whatnot, without that waist strap, it's not going to do real well for any sort of long-term day hiking. It does have a sternum strap here. Sternum straps are not are removable here, so they're not permanently attached. I'm not sure how I feel about that. It does have a grab handle here that has rubber around it, so that's kind of nice. It's not just blank nylon. Does have a pocket up top here. It is felt lined. They say these are for your glasses or your goggles. I would never just throw my glasses in here without being in the microfiber bag or another case. But if you choose to do so, there's a quick access pouch here across the top. So I'm going to try to show you my attempt to fit in everything that I carry or deem necessary for the range in a moment here. All right, so this is what I carry in that LA Police Gear bag. That's a 46 liter bag, and I'm compressing it down to 23 liters. So I just realized as I finally opened up my bag and emptied all the pockets, I do have some redundancy here. So I have 2 things of bug spray. I can consolidate that. These are all of my club IDs. I definitely have 2 staple guns here. This one's super cool. I'll be doing a review on this carbon fiber job. Pretty awesome. This is the backup stapler. I got the 2 staples there. I've got a bunch of pens and stuff here. I've got my Allen and Torx. Got some paperwork for tax stamp paperwork. I carry this ammo can. In the ammo can, there's going to be some ammo, spare ammo, just in case I forget stuff. Short mag for zeroing. I have an oops kit here for the AR. probably consolidate that into here. I've got my med bag, med kit. I have a bottle of loot, CLP here. I found another bottle of CLP here. Boar snake, spotting scope, and a bunch of rags here. So I'm going to try to consolidate this. Oh, and I also have my shot timer there and my spotting scope. So lots of crap. I'm going to try to kind of get this organized, and then we're going to try to pack it all, or as much as we can, into the link pack. And I forgot two more things. A tripod for the spotting scope and range paperwork. I don't know if I talked about the spotting scope here, but there you go. So, I will get to consolidating, and then we'll see. Oh yeah, range flags, chamber flags as well. So yeah, carry a lot of crap. Let's me try to get this kind of organized, and then we'll start packing the bag. All right, so I've consolidated some stuff. I wanted to show you how I packed this ammo can. So I've got some 5.56 in here. This is some Freedom Munitions. I believe this is 223. If you can see that. Do a lot of zeroing for customer builds, so it's always good to get to the range. And if I forget ammo for the customer, at least I have some spare ammo here. Short mag, 10 round. I think it's a 20 rounder. So it's easier to bench the rifle. I have some 9mm just in case I go to the range and forgot my pistol ammo or run out. Got an extra buffer here. The oops kit here, so it's a bunch of springs. And then I have a nickel ball and bolt in here. And that's pretty much it for what's gonna go on here. That'll get closed up, and we'll put that in the range bag in a second. Then I took all those rags, compressed them down to one, got the one bottle of CLP now, and put my pens in a Ziploc bag. I've got the 22 caliber boar snake, so the boar snake's for the AR. That's all packed separately now as well. So these should fit into the side pockets. I've got my Allen and Torx and my little mini screwdriver compressed into a bag here. Got my Gerber multi-tool. Those two I'll just have loose. Still trying to figure these two out. Got the target plates there. Those will go in the main pocket. Tissues, just probably grab one thing of bug spray. And I'm going to see if that spotting scope will fit in as well. And of course, my ID. So we'll get going on that in a second. Med pouch is going to molly onto the outside. I'm going to, it's black, but I'll try to get one that quote unquote matches, because you know, you got to look good too. So let me get everything, the camera set up back in a tripod here, and then we'll start packing away and see how we do. All right, first things first, I'm going to start with my range paperwork. I'm gonna throw that back here in the hydration pouch. Hopefully that pouch will expand wide enough for this to fit. I did have an internal stiffener from another bag. I tried to get it to fit, and just this pouch isn't deep enough, nor is it wide enough for it to fit. So next thing I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna take the ammo can, and I'm going to get that shoved in here as well. So let's see if this ammo can goes in like I was hoping it would. Just straight up and down, and that's going to provide a little bit of stiffening. I don't know if you guys can see that. So that's all in there. So just noting the size here, this is not going to fit. So my spotting scope is just not going to work here. I was really trying to avoid hanging stuff on the outside, but it looks like I'm going to have to. Once I have that in, my paper plate targets here. They'll go in there. Now the med kit, I'm just going to molly off onto the sides here on that molly right there. And we have all these side pockets. We have this pocket up top. I'm gonna put my range IDs up here. I'm gonna put the carbon fiber stapler up here, see if it fits behind the range IDs. Just fits or barely fits here. So we're gonna have to find another spot for that. Close that up. So I may just have to have the stapler here just hanging out inside the bag. Side pocket on this side. I'm gonna put my rangefinder. I'm gonna go off into the side here. Throw my multi-tool in there. My teepee. Never know when you're gonna have to go in the woods. All right. One thing I'm not liking already about this bag, again, no internal stiffener, no waist belt, and no double zipper, only one single zipper here that I get to work with. So not a huge fan of that. These are gonna go in the bottom. My pens, I'm gonna shove them off in the side here. Probably just throw the timer in here. And then zip that off. It's got a cool key ring thing here if you wanted to throw your keys in there. All right, so there is room up front here, so I'm gonna toss my bug spray down in there. Oops, kit is already up front there. And I'll probably put the staples, since there's room in this top flap, I'm going to throw my staples in there. So two different packs of staples for the two staple guns. I will throw my chamber flags in there as well, since they're small, don't take up much space. Business cards. And that's pretty much it for the big stuff. I think I might be able to squeeze the spotting scope in just barely. It's not there's just that little gap right there where the, I don't know if you guys can see that, where that bug spray is. Probably fit spotting scope in. There you go. All right. And second stapler. Just chuck that in there. Now, we are missing some cleaning stuff, so main compartment does have the double zippers. They are reinforced, which is kind of nice. So if I flip this over, see what I could do with putting the cleaning stuff down here. So I've got my borsnake, my rags, my CLP. I can just shove that in there. And again, single zipper. So again, I'm not too much of a fan here of single zippers. That seam looks like it's pretty stressed. We'll see about that. So that's it. Looks like it's been packed up, ready for me to throw it. Oh, sorry about that. Throw it in the Jeep and try to use this for a little bit. I will be doing a 6-year review on the bag that this is replacing. And you'll see why I'm a big fan of that LA police gear bag and that. I'll also, once that's done and published, I'll put a link to that in the description as well. So all I have to do now is go ahead and attach this Molly first aid kit. I'm actually going to attach it to one of the sides here. Trying to keep this bag thin in terms, or flat. I don't care if it goes wide because of how I want to load it into the Jeep. So, forcing myself to reorganize the range bag. Initial thoughts, there's a couple things, again, that I don't like about this bag, but I am only using it as a range bag. I'm not going to be taking it out into the field and hiking with it or walking around with it, carrying substantial amounts of weight with it. So far, it's set up like every other Oakley bag. It's good for how it looks, but in the real world, not sure how they're going to hold up. So that's it. If you are interested in one of these bags, I'll put a link to the product in the description as well. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you like what we do here, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Go ahead and click on that bell icon. Should be off to the right there, and you'll get notified when we publish more content. We try to publish content at least once a week, but sometimes may get busy, may not be able to get stuff out. As always, stay safe, and we'll see you out on the range.